Well, hey guys, it's Catherine from CatherinePuller.com, and in today's video, we're going to use the Still Smiling stamp set along with Fiesta Blue, Lime Rickey Party Dress, and Midnight Ink. I made a really clean and simple card. This is just a one-layer card. I used our note cards that come pre-cut and pre-scored. Those are in our store, and I just made a cute thank you card. So now I'm going to take the same design idea, but I'm going to step it up a few notches. First, I have a 4 by 5 1/4 inch piece of cardstock. I'm going to use this for a layer on my card, and I want it to be a little technique piece. So the first thing I'm going to do is sponge it with Party Dress, and I'm using a fairly light hand with my ink applicator tool, starting off the cardstock on my mat, and that will help give a less streaky look. I'm concentrating around the edges because I am going to do a technique on top, and then I'm going to add a layer. So we won't need to pay too much attention to the center. And if I get a little impatient and start going too fast or pushing down too hard with my ink applicator tool and I get some streakiness or uneven ink blending, it's not really a problem because, like I said, I'm going to do a technique over the top. I'm going to do some stenciling, so I'm going to add a little adhesive to the back. This will help my layer stay put and not move around on the work surface. I'm going to use the Checkerboard Stencil. I'm lining this up so that it is even in the same spot on each side and top to bottom. And I have a little painter's tape. Just going to secure the stencil in place. I have whip spackle and my palette knife. I'm gonna scoop some out. If you haven't ever used whip spackle before, it's a really fun medium to use with stencils. You can also mix it with ink and have colored spackle, which is really cool. It is kind of, if you're familiar with embossing paste, it's like an embossing paste. It's the consistency to the whip spackle is more like frosting. I really like using it because, I mean, come on. Who doesn't like frosting? And I'm just spreading this evenly over my background. Add the rest back into the container. Put my lid on. I'm gonna peel this back. Really cool checkerboard pattern. Now, I know some of my stamping friends keep a little tub of soapy water, which is really fabulous because you don't want to let the whip spackle dry, because if you do, it's going to stay put. I want this glittery. I don't have any regular glitter. All I have is embossing glitter. So I'm going to use that, and I'm just going to sprinkle some over the top. And the whip spackle is still wet, so it's going to catch that glitter. And then I'm going to have a gorgeous glittered stenciled checkerboard. Now, if I wanted to heat that, I could. Or I could just let it dry as is. So I'm hitting this with my heat tool a bit. It's probably hard for you guys to see on camera. It's actually hard for me to see in person too. But when you heat the whip spackle, it bubbles up just a little. So it just kind of depends on the look you're going for. If you just wanted to leave it to give a glitzy, glittery look, you can, because it will dry right into that whip spackle. Or if you want to heat it, that is fine too. So here's how it's shaping up so far. We have this fun technique piece with a card base behind it. And then I thought I would use the Merry Labels die. This comes with the large label, the small label, and then Merry and Joy sentiment dies. And it makes a really great embossed frame around the edge. So it's a very nice accent to your cards. So I'm going to use the Still Smiling, the thanks and the flowers. I'm not exactly sure how much space I'm going to have between the thanks and the flowers. I have all these great little sentiments in this stamp set to add, but I'm going to do that last because I want to see how much room I have. So we're going to start with the thanks, and I'm using one of our new blocks with the grid, the long one that's great for sentiments. And then I'm going to stamp this really cute flower at the bottom. We'll do the pink first. And then we'll clean it off in between and do Fiesta Blue and Lime Rickey. And then I have just a little bit of space there in between the flowers and the thanks to do one of those fun greetings. So I've chosen My Heart Is Still Smiling. I can use that for all sorts of different occasions. And I just lined up the bottom of the sentiment with my grid line, and that will help me line it up on the label. And now we'll assemble, just adding a little adhesive to the back of my technique piece, adding it to the card front. And then I think this label needs to be popped up. So I'm gonna grab my giant roll of 3M mounting tape and add that label. That'll go right in the center. And that's it. You know, I think one of my favorite things is taking clean and simple cards and adding techniques and layers and other fun products to make it a step up. Hope you guys enjoy these videos. All of these products are available in our store. All the links are below. And that's all for now. Hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll speak to you soon.